कोई मिल गया, मेरा दिल गया, क्या बताऊं यारो, मैं तो हिल गया, कोई मिल गया।
Right, so let's learn this very, very groovy song, Koi Mil Gaya. And this is on the key of B flat major. That's the original scale. However, you could play it on any scale, probably depending on your vocal range. As you know, in the original song, the female singer goes insanely high, right? I don't know how many of you can even pitch that note. So you may need to transpose it up or down a notch, or maybe you want to sing higher than her. I don't know. So anyway, so basically you have a verse and a chorus, and then you have another verse. The next verse is basically repeated, I guess, a couple of times, right? It's repeated about two or three times. So let's just try the main part, which is verse one. Then there's also a pre-chorus. Just before the chorus. Okay, so let's try and do the verse. And before that, I'm going to show you the rhythm on the key of B flat itself, or rather on the chord of B flat. Try to follow this rhythm for pretty much the entire song, unless you feel you want to make the song a little less busy. And then you can perhaps play the song or play the chords a little bit more open. Just hold it and wait for it to change. Okay, so this is my rhythm. So B flat chord octave twice, and then the chord. Dum, 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 dum. Now, if you don't like playing the octave, you can also play the fifth. Let me show you with the fifth. Actually, I quite like the fifth more because it adds some color. When you change your chords, and in the right hand, try to play your chords close to each other using a concept called inversions. If you already know your inversions, well and good. If you don't, try and keep them together. And we'll also leave a link in the description where you can learn some of my other tutorials, and we have a series on chord inversion, so you may want to check that out if you're not aware of playing your chords that fluently on the piano. Right, so let's get down with the verse, and the verse is ridiculously easy. It's B flat and A flat, B flat and A flat. However, you need to play this with this really funky rhythm which we just came up with, and then you change to A flat. Right, and then the pre-chorus goes into C minor, A flat major, F major, and stop at B flat. That takes us to our chorus. Okay, so pre-chorus, don't play the groovy thing, try and hold your chords. Right, so with Naveen, let's try and do the verse. A 1, 2, 3, 4. B flat. A flat, B flat, A flat, A flat, A flat, A flat, and then goes back to our chorus. Okay, so again, recapping on our verse one, which is repeated, I guess, one more time in the track. B flat, A flat, B flat, A flat, B flat, A flat, B flat, A flat, and now the pre, na 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 na, A flat, F, stop. Okay, so the last line is just the singer. You can stop playing your instrument. Okay, coming to the chorus, basically you do an alternate of B flat major and F major, and then B flat major and F major. That's pretty much the deal throughout the chorus. And then he ends the chorus with an E flat seventh, which adds a lot of anticipation, and it leads us to the next instrumental part. So it's B flat F, B flat F, and then koi mil gaya. So that's E flat dominant. How do you play that? That's sa 1 3 5, E flat G B flat, and then you add the flat 7, which is D flat. Okay, so let's now try the chorus with Naveen singing. And I've also marked out the fact that the chorus chords, I've put these double dots here. That means the chord is repeated for two bars, right? So, again, na 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 na, and so on. So, play the chords in the chorus, double their duration.
Koi mil gaya.
To that part, you go, your chords need to change a bit faster. So you go B flat, E flat, B flat, F, B flat, E flat, B flat, F. So this is basically 1 4 1 5. So if you were on any scale, if it's not B flat, you just have to do 1 of that, 4 of that, 1 of that, and then 5 of that. So in the B flat scale, which is the original scale of the song, it's B flat, E flat, and F. That's the 1 4 5. Okay, we'll do the chorus once more, perhaps a little slower, and then we'll count out the chords as we play along. F major, B flat again, F again, E flat, stop, B flat, E flat, B flat, F, B flat, E flat, B flat, F, and it repeats. So the chords just change a bit faster there. And what else? There's also another verse, right? So let's try and do the next verse, which is going to again repeat a couple more times. So you'll find the same tune. Whenever the next verse comes, try to play these chords. The good thing about this song is it's pretty much major chord driven. If you know your three major chords of any major scale, like in C major, the major chords are C, F, and G. In G major, the major chords are G, C, and D, and so on. This happens to be on B flat. Try to not get that scared when it's a flat scale or a non-natural scale. You can get used to it because the original is on this. So more often than not, a singer would prefer to sing on the original scale since they've heard this song all their lives, right? So changing the scale starts becoming a little bit of an issue. So only change the scale if the singer demands it, in my opinion. Otherwise, try to learn it on the original. And then if you have to change it, you know what to do, right? So let's do verse number 2, please. Back to the chorus. Okay, so that's the same groove, but it's just a different assortment of the chords. However, just note you have a very interesting A flat major chord, which is not part of the key, right? Let's try and do verse 2 a little slower with me counting down the chords. 1, 2, three, four.
जाने क्या हो गया है मुझे दीवाना लोग कहने लगे
A flat
दीवानगी है क्या
E flat
मैं तो हो पता
F
तुमको क्या हो गया
and that's into two and then it goes back to our chorus. So also know that I've marked out some other chords, some other sections like a bridge where people are humming and all sorts of instrumentation is happening. As you know, there's a lot of instrumentation which goes on in Bollywood songs. So it's going to be difficult to fit all that in into one video. However, if you'd like to learn something specific, do let us know in the comments and we'll be happy to help you out. So go through the chord sheet. It's an awesome groovy song. So have some fun playing it with your band. Cheers. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that bell icon for notifications. Leave us a comment for any other video you'd like us to do next. And don't forget to share the video with all your musician friends. Cheers.